Hutch, I just looked at a movie. Half Nelson is a little independent film that has received such rave reviews that you might be disappointed when you find yourself not enjoying it as much as you expected to. Just wait, however, because you will eventually begin enjoying it more and more as it reaches its climax. Blame the very interesting camera work and editing for preventing you from falling in love with this film at the beginning as much as you will at the end. The story and some of the characters are confusing at times, too, but you will soon realize that doesn't make any difference as you come to appreciate and admire the film for its intelligence and wrenching impact. Ryan Gosling plays Dan Dunne, a very good 8th grade history teacher in an almost all-black middle school who has a very bad drug problem. And like all addicts, he deceives himself most of all by saying that he does drugs now just to get by, but he can handle it. At one point he says, "The kids keep me focused." One of his students is a 13-year-old black girl named Dre, played excellently by Sharika Epps. She's also on the girls' basketball team that Dunne coaches, and one night after a game, Dre finds him stoned in the girls' locker room. Neither one of them makes a big deal about it, and together they share this secret as an unlikely growing friendship develops between them in and outside of class and on the basketball court. The title, of course, refers to a wrestling hold in which you are only half stuck, as opposed to being completely stuck in a full Nelson. Dre has a family member who deals drugs, and if both she and Dunne don't do something drastic in their lives, you get the feeling that they are both on the path to being caught in a full Nelson. The history of the civil rights movement plays a part in the story, but it's mostly about the two main characters and a slice of the underbelly of their lives and friendship. Half Nelson might be a little hard to take with its cross-cutting, editing, and duplicate themes. It has a climax that will break your heart, and it's not so much an acquired taste as it is an acquired admiration. I'm Dan Culberson, and this is Hot Shots.